Hello, everybody. I am Professor Pierre Tadevin. I am the chair of the Alliance for the Prudent Use of Antibiotics, the APUA, and we are glad to celebrate our 40th anniversary together with the 60th anniversary of the International Society of Antimicrobial Chemotherapy of ISAC. For those of you who are not familiar with APUA, we have to tell a word about its founder, Stuart Levy, who decided in 1981 to found APUA to raise the awareness about the emergence of antimicrobial resistance and its potential consequences, and to promote the ways to control it with appropriate use of antibiotics and infection control activities. Stuart Levy was not a beginner. A few years earlier, he has published landmark papers in 1976 in Nature and in the New England Journal of Medicine that you may call the early years of the One Health concept. Through experiments in farm animals, he used chicken cages. Some of them were fed with tetracyclines, some of them without tetracycline, and he could prove many important points. The early emergence of resistance as soon as you give antibiotics to the animals, including humans, the high transmissibility of this resistance, and this transmissibility is even improved if you feed the contact with tetracyclines due to the selective pressure. And it could also document that you can transmit the resistance to the farmers. And one of the conclusions of this work by himself was that this data speaks strongly against the unqualified and unlimited use of drug feeds in animals as a boundary and speak for the revolution of this form of widespread treatment of animals. And if you look, it was in 1976, so probably 40 years before the One Health became a popular concept, so really a pioneer in the field. From that time, APUA has many activities, and I invite you to look at the website if you want to be more informed that, but basically APUA did a lot of communication and lobbying that probably had important impact on agencies such as WHO, CDC, or FDA. APUA built an international network with chapters in up to 58 countries in the world. They did a lot of support for education and research in the field, and we also had a lot of activities for advocacy to promote antimicrobial stewardship all over the world, with a special focus in the countries who are probably the most in need now, the developing countries, also called low and middle income countries. The perspectives for the years to come, we are currently working on guidelines for directed therapy for main pathogens. It will be free access based on the platform, easily adaptable so that each country can adapt it to the problem he has with resistance or the antibiotics that are available in the country or in the hospital. And that will be complementary to the WHO empirical antibiotic treatment guidelines that are about to be published. We work on antibiotic cards, one-page cards that will say all what you need to know for better use of each important antibiotics. And we will work more with our international network, including in low and middle income countries, project for collaboration with many agencies that are listed here. We will work together with ISAC to promote the research on better use of antibiotics with grants and educational activities through the ISAC Academy platform. We will go on with our regular communication through newsletters or the update of our website. We will work to the rebirth of the APUA international chapters that have been quite difficult to activate over the last 2 years due to the COVID, but we are ready to begin again. And we will also have a lot of intervention in webinars, national and international conference with the same aim to raise the awareness on the antimicrobial resistance and the way to control it. So to finish, this is the board I have the pleasure to work with now. And if you want to know more, please visit us at the https.apua.org.